One of the most discouraging thyroid symptoms that I hear about from my female patients is the struggle with belly fat. Sometimes no matter what you do, how much you exercise, how much you clean up your diet and lifestyle changes that you make, the weight scale just doesn't want to budge. Now I'm going to share with you why you can't lose weight around the belly, despite all this dieting and exercising and hours on the treadmill, and what you need to do in order to kickstart your metabolism, get this thyroid working with you, not against you. See, not all belly fat is created equal. A patient with thyroid disease who develops belly fat is very different than the belly fat than the person who does not have thyroid disease. And this is why when you try to implement many of the same strategies for someone trying to lose weight, it doesn't work in those thyroid patients. And a lot of this has to do with how thyroid hormones influence hormones that regulate your appetite, how they influence energy production and energy usage, and finally, metabolism and fat storage. With that in mind, let's talk more about the connection between thyroid problems and belly fat, and really how to solve it. Now, if you're serious about your weight loss, getting this belly fat under control, your body needs to be burning sugar for energy, not saving it for a rainy day. But that's not what's happening in the vast majority of people with thyroid disease. Many people with thyroid disease also have blood sugar problems like pre-diabetes or maybe more advanced states. Maybe they're diabetic, maybe they have hypoglycemia, or they're insulin resistant. And when you're insulin sensitive, your body does a great job at turning sugar into glucose from your diet into energy and burning it. But that all comes to a grinding halt when you become insulin resistant. You don't want to be insulin resistant. Not only is this one foot in the door to becoming a diabetic, insulin resistance also causes you to store fat in the belly and midsection. Now, if you're new to my channel, I've done numerous videos on this particular topic, this connection between blood sugar and thyroid function, and I'll leave links in the comments section of today's video. But here's what I want you to know. Insulin resistance is incredibly common, with as many as 50% of adults suffering from this condition, and these numbers are even increased in patients with thyroid disease. So why is insulin resistance such a problem for people with thyroid disease? Well, like I mentioned a moment ago, people suffering with thyroid disease are already at increased risk for developing insulin resistance, all right? And this is because both in hyperthyroidism and in hypothyroidism, there's an interference with the insulin signaling, and that makes you more likely to develop insulin resistance. In addition, insulin resistance causes your blood sugar to go up and down and causes your insulin levels to roller coaster and go up and down. And every time your blood sugar drops, your adrenal glands spring into action by increasing another hormone called cortisol. And if you have low cortisol levels, your cells make it harder to take in thyroid hormone. Insulin resistance includes a host of problems, which include things like heart attacks and strokes and obesity and cancer and metabolic syndrome and polycystic ovarian syndrome, all things that you see listed here. In addition, insulin resistance increases your hunger. So you eat more and this makes you gain weight in your abdomen. But the good news is that if you have insulin resistance and you catch it early enough, you can prevent all these future problems that I just mentioned. Well, how do you know if you have insulin resistance? Well, you need to have some blood tests being done. But here's the thing, you can't rely on a single glucose measurement for any reliable information as it pertains to blood sugar. What you really need is you need a fasting insulin test and you need a hemoglobin A1C test. And if you have your reverse T3 levels and your T3 levels or free T3, you can also calculate that ratio, which again is another indicator for insulin resistance. Now I'm going to leave a link on this information in the description box. And so if you're watching this on YouTube, otherwise if you're watching this on my website, all the links will be provided for you at the end of the article. The video that you'll want to watch is 12 tips to balancing your blood sugar when you have thyroid disease. And the article, Dr. Hagmeyer explains the hidden causes of your thyroid disease, blood sugar. Now, the suggestions that I go over in these articles and this video is not only effective for reversing insulin resistance, but they're also very powerful weight loss strategies as well. So if you're a diabetic, a pre-diabetic, hypoglycemic, you'll obviously want to watch these and read those articles, because we know that if you're not burning sugar for energy, your body is storing it in the form of belly fat and high triglycerides. So there you go. If you have questions about today's video, as always, drop them in the comment section below. If you're interested in working with my clinic, you can reach out to me by visiting my website and scheduling an initial phone consultation. If you haven't already downloaded my free thyroid guide, you can do that again by visiting my website and clicking on that free guide section, downloading that appropriate guide. And lastly, if you like today's video, after hitting that like button or subscribing to my channel, I recommend that you watch this video next. Thank you.